Hello guys, welcome to my channel Chem Insider. So in today's class we are going to discuss about a topic from solutions chapter, that is about the second colligative property. So the second colligative property, third colligative property, that is depression in freezing point. In the previous video we have discussed about the effect of adding solute to a solvent, whereas we discussed two important colligative properties. Those are relative lowering of vapor pressure and elevation in boiling point, right? Since we know from class 11, whenever you add certain solutes to a solvent, its vapor pressure decreases. Now let us consider a liquid, that is nothing but a solvent which you are considering in this particular condition. If you take a solvent such as a liquid of its pure content and vary its temperature and decrease its temperature, what happens is it has to convert themselves to a solid component. Like for example, if this is a liquid which I have taken, let us say water. So water forms ice when it freezes, right? So water forms ice when it freezes. That is, we are taking the temperature to a lower section. That is, we are decreasing the temperature in order to make this water to get frozen to form an ice. So this process of freezing takes place when the vapor pressure of the solvent in the liquid phase will be equal to vapor pressure of the solvent in its solid phase. When you consider a solvent and it has to convert from liquid to solid, it only freezes from liquid to solid when its vapor pressure of its liquid state becomes equal to the vapor pressure of its solid phase. Like for example, if you draw the graph of vapor pressure versus temperature for a given solvent, so let us say we are taking y-axis as a vapor pressure, we have taken vapor pressure on y-axis and temperature along x-axis, okay. So now we are considering solvent in both solid and liquid condition. So what happens is, if this is the liquid solvent, if you are considering the liquid solvent, its vapor pressure will be in this way. That is, if you increase the temperature, vapor pressure increases. Okay. So now if you are decreasing the temperature, vapor pressure will be decreasing. Further, the same liquid solvent, the same solvent has a different vapor pressure in its solid phase. Okay. Vapor pressure of a solvent in liquid phase and in solid phase are quite different with respect to the temperature. So if this is considered as the vapor pressure for a solvent in liquid phase, then the vapor pressure of the solvent in solid phase will be like this. Okay. So the vapor pressure of a solid phase and the vapor pressure of the liquid phase meet at certain point of temperature, and that point of temperature is called its freezing point. So this is called its freezing point. This particular temperature is called its freezing point, denoted by the symbol T1. Okay, so T1 naught. When you consider solvent in its liquid phase and in solid phase, it clearly has two different vapor pressure curves with respect to temperature. But when you observe for those two, they only freeze at particular point where the vapor pressure of in solid state and the vapor pressure of itself in the liquid phase meets one another at a particular temperature. And that particular temperature is called its freezing point, T1 naught for a pure solvent. Now, when you add solute, what happens here is, we know from the elevation in boiling point explanation itself, the solvent solution's vapor pressure decreases, right? Now, the vapor pressure of the solution will be lesser than that of the vapor pressure of the solvent in the liquid phase, and those meet with the vapor pressure of solvent in the liquid phase at a different temperature. Okay, let us say this one. So this will be T1 temperature, that is freezing point of solution which has certain amount of solute. So if you consider this as vapor pressure of liquid solvent and this is vapor pressure of liquid solution, okay, and this is vapor pressure of solid solvent. So when the vapor pressure of liquid solvent meets the vapor pressure of solid solvent, then that particular temperature point will be called as freezing point of a pure solvent. And similarly, when the vapor pressure of liquid solution meets the vapor pressure of the solid solvent, then that point of temperature is called the freezing point of given solution. So clearly, if you observe here, we have reduced the freezing point of solvent by adding solutes. So this difference between the temperature is called as delta TF, which is called as the depression in freezing point. So depression in freezing point means the decrease in the lowering in freezing point of a pure solvent when an amount of solute is added, which depends upon its mole fraction. So delta TF is directly proportional to the amount of solute added. So therefore, delta TF can be written as directly proportional to M, that is molality of the solute which you are considering. So therefore, delta TF is equal to KF of M. Delta TF is equal to KF of M, where KF is called ebullioscopic freezing constant. Sorry, delta KF is called depression in freezing point constant. Delta KF is called depression in freezing point constant. It is also named as cryoscopic constant. Cryoscopic constant. So this cryoscopic constant KF completely depends upon the nature of the solute which you are adding. Okay, whereas delta TF depends upon only on the molality of the solute. Okay. So what you are understanding over here is whenever the vapor pressure of the pure solvent meets the vapor pressure of the solid solvent, then that particular point of temperature will be called as the freezing point of pure solvent. And when you add solutes to the solvent, what happens is its liquid solution decreases its vapor pressure, and therefore it meets at a different point with the vapor pressure of solid solvent, and that particular temperature is called as the freezing point of solution. So clearly from the figure we can say that delta TF, that is a freezing point, depression in freezing point, can be observed when you add solutes to a given solvent, and it is proportional to molality of the solutes which you are adding, and it given by the equation delta TF is equal to KF into M, where KF is called the cryoscopic constant. Now, how to determine the molar mass of the solute added using this depression in freezing point constant? So now, if you have understood in the elevation boiling point concept, molality M is equal to given as, molality is given as number of moles of solute divided by mass of solvent in kilograms, right? Molality is equal to number of moles of solute divided by mass of solvent in kg, right? Mass of solvent in kg. So therefore, number of moles of solute, if you consider solute as second component, then number of moles is given by N2. Number of moles will be given by N2, which is nothing but given mass divided by molar mass, W2 by M2. So writing directly over here, W2 by M2 whole divided by W1 divided by 1000. So this, what happens here is, this 1000 relates to kilo. Okay, usually we get the weight of solvent in terms of grams. We have to convert the grams into 1000. What we do is divided it by 1000. Okay, so now M is equal to W2 by M2 whole divided by W1 by 1000. So let us take this as equation 1, and substituting the molar concentration, molality of the solution in the delta TF equation, delta TF is equal to KF into W2 by M2. So taking this reciprocal on the numerator, it becomes 1000 by W1. So the equation delta TF will be equal to KF into W2 into 1000 divided by M2 into W1. So if you have to find out the molar mass of a solute, so M2 will be equal to KF into W2 into 1000 divided by delta TF into W1. So this will be the equation which you have to use in order to determine the molar mass of a solute. Okay, so this is about the equation which you have to use in order to find out the molar mass of a solute if its freezing, the lowering freezing point is given and the freezing constant or cryoscopic constant is given. Okay, so this is about the explanation of depression in freezing point. Okay, so now we have discussed about two special constants. Those are cryoscopic constant and ebullioscopic constant. Okay, we have discussed about cryoscopic constant and ebullioscopic constant. This cryoscopic constant and ebullioscopic constant depends upon heat of vaporization and heat of fusion. Boiling constant depends upon heat of vaporization, whereas freezing constant depends upon vapor of enthalpy of fusion. Okay, so those values are cryoscopic constant and ebullioscopic constants are given by the equation Kf is equal to R into M2 into Tf square divided by 1000 into delta H of fusion, and whereas Kb is given by the equation R into molar mass of the solute into square of change in temperature is boiling point of the solution divided by 1000 into delta H of vaporization. Okay, remember boiling means nothing but converting the liquid to gas, vaporization, whereas Kf means freezing, means you are converting it, so fusing the components. So therefore Kf is equal to Rm2, that is molar mass of the solute, into temperature or freezing point of solution the whole square divided by 1000 into delta H of fusion, whereas ebullioscopic constant is calculated by the formula Rm2 Tb square divided by 1000 into delta H of vaporization. Okay, so this is about the two formulas which were used to calculate ebullioscopic constant and cryoscopic constant. So if you observe over here, these values are not much of a difference, but what happens here is because of its particular solutes delta H of fusion and delta H of vaporization, Kf depends upon the nature of the solute which you are using. Okay, Kf and Kb depends upon the nature of the solute, because different solutes have different heat of fusion and heat of vaporization. Okay, so this is about the derivation for depression in freezing point. Let us solve the problems which I have given on the right hand side. So the first question says, we have given 45 grams of ethanol which is dissolved in 600 grams of water. If the cryoscopic constant of water is 1.86 Kelvin kg per mole, calculate delta Tf, that is lowering in vapor pressure, lowering in freezing point and boiling point of water when the solute is added. For the given data from the equation, they have given us 45 grams of C2H6O2 is dissolved in 600 grams of water. So that is W2 is equal to 45 grams. Okay. And further, they have given us the molecular formula which will be useful for calculating its molar mass. That is C2H6O2 means 12 into 2 plus 6 into 1 plus 16 into 2. 16 for oxygen. So total gives us 62 grams. So molar mass of solute C2H6O2 is nothing but ethylene diol is 62 grams per mole. Okay. So next they have given us mass of water, that is W1 is equal to 600 gram. And further they have given us Kf is equal to 1.86 Kelvin kg per mole. Okay. So let us now directly write down the formula for calculation. That is delta Tf is equal to Kf into M. Delta Tf is equal to Kf into M. So if you write down the substituents, whatever I have to take, that is Kf into M can be written as, instead of M, you can write the other formula where Kf is delta Tf is equal to Kf into W2 into 1000 divided by M2 into W1. So on substituting those values, we get 1.86 into 45 grams multiplied by 1000 whole divided by molar mass of ethanol dial is 62 into what we have is weight 600. Okay, so these are all the constants which you are going to substitute. So two zeros, two zeros get cancelled. On simplifying all this value, we get delta TF as 2.2 Kelvin. So that is lowering of freezing point because of adding a solute to water gives us a decrease in 2.2 Kelvin. This solute is being the C2H6O2. Next is they have asked us to calculate the boiling point of water once the solute is added. Now T of water is equal to delta TF minus, sorry, T1 naught minus delta TF, because it has to be reduced in the pure solvent. So now what is T1 naught? That is freezing point of water. That is 273.15 Kelvin. It is a constant. Freezing point of water is 0 degree Celsius. It is also called 273.15 Kelvin minus 2.2 Kelvin, which gives us the value 270.95 Kelvin. So this is the boiling point of solutions of ethanol and water mixture. Okay, so this is how we calculate the problem of delta TF determination. Okay, so now we'll go for the next one. That is the second one. In the second question, they have asked us to determine the molar mass of the solute added. Okay, they haven't given us the molecular formula of the solute. They're asking us to determine the molar mass of the solute. And further, they have given us certain different constants. Those are values such as W2, which is 1 gram. Mass of the solute is 1 gram. Next, mass of solvent is 50 grams. Mass of solvent is 50 grams. Next, they have given us compound is benzene. Next is Kf, that is cryoscopic constant, which is 5.12 Kelvin kg per mole. Okay, next. And they have given delta TF, which is equals to 0.40 Kelvin. So now they have asked us to calculate M2, that is equals to question mark. So formula is M2 is equal to cryoscopic constant into W2 into 1000 whole divided by W1 into delta TF. Okay. So now cryoscopic constant is 5.12. into W2 is 1 gram into 1000 whole divided by 50 grams of benzene into delta TF is 0.40 Kelvin. So substituting these values, we get 256 grams per mole. So this is the molar mass of the solute which you are adding to the 50 grams of solvent of benzene. Okay. So this is all about the problems which you have to determine the molar mass using delta TF and cryoscopic constant values. I hope you have understood this third colligative property. In the next class, we'll be discussing about osmotic pressure and osmosis, which is a very important concept for colligative property. If you have understood this video, please comment on. If you have understood this video, please subscribe to my channel and share this among your friends. If you have any doubts, please do comment down below. Thank you for watching.